Well, good Sunday morning to you folks there in Myrtle Beach at Portside. My name is George Vastine. It's good to be with you. And we will start our time of devotion this morning with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. All right, we're going to go ahead and read Matthew 11, 25 through 30 before we read our story from the daily bread this morning. 25 through 30 says, At that time Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. All things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. We'll go ahead and read now from our daily bread for today, Sunday, September the 26th. Matthew 11, 28, Come unto me, all ye who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Rest well. The clock blinked 1:55 a.m., burdened by a late-night text conversation. Sleep wasn't coming. I unwound the mummy-like clutch of my tangled sheets and padded quietly to the couch. I Googled what to do to fall asleep, but instead found what not to do. Don't take a nap or drink caffeine or work out late in the day. Check. Reading further on my tablet, I was advised not to use screen time late either. Oops. Texting hadn't been a good idea. When it comes to resting well, there are lists of what not to do. In the Old Testament, God handed down rules regarding what not to do on the Sabbath in order to embrace rest. In the New Testament, Jesus offered a new way. Rather than stressing regulations, Jesus called the disciples into relationship. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. In the preceding verse, Jesus pointed to his own ongoing relationship of oneness with his Father, the one he's revealed to us. The provision of ongoing help Jesus enjoyed from the Father is one we can experience as well. While we're wise to avoid certain pastimes that can interrupt our sleep, resting well in Christ has more to do with relationship than regulation. I clicked my reader off and laid my burdened heart down on the pillow of Jesus' invitation. Come to me. How does viewing rest as a relationship rather than a regulation change your view of rest? In what area of your life is Jesus calling you to rest in relationship with him? Pretty good questions. How does viewing rest as a relationship rather than a regulation change your view of rest? For me, it's nice to know that it is comforting to be able to go to the Lord, tell him my burden, lay it down there, and leave it there with him. And if I can leave it there with him, I can find a rest in that. Okay, this song goes right along with what we read today. One of my favorite songs out of the hymn book I sing out of, and so maybe you'll enjoy it as well. Hear the blessed Savior calling the oppressed. O ye heavy laden, come to me and rest. Come no longer tarry, I your load will bear. Bring me every burden, bring me every care. Come unto me, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, hear me and be blessed. Come and trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden's light. Are you disappointed, wandering here and there, dragging chains of doubt and loaded down with care? Do unholy feelings struggle in your breast? Bring your case to Jesus, he will give you rest. Come unto me, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, hear me and be blessed. Trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden's light. Stumbling on the mountain, dark with sin and shame, stumbling toward the pit of hell's eternal flame, by the power of sin, deluded and distressed. Come right on to Jesus, he will give you rest. Come unto me, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, hear me and be blessed. I am meek and lowly. Come and trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden's light. Have you by temptation often conquered been? Has a sense of weakness brought distress within? Christ will sanctify you if you claim his best. In the Holy Spirit, he will give you rest. Come unto me, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, hear me and be blessed. I am meek and lowly. Come and trust my mind. Come, my yoke is easy and my burden light. Thank you, Trish. Thank you, staff. God bless you, folks, and we'll see you again next Sunday. Have a great week.